Calling all tech and or fashion nerds, today we are answering the not age-old question, but it's a question, can one mix fashion and coding successfully? In this video, I'm going to tell you the story of how we used the CodeX to make a living dress. So stick around, cause it's pretty cool. So without further ado, let us begin. On January 20th, 2023, this email arrived. I won't make you read all of that, but in summary, Ms. Ariel Bergman is following up with our company president, David, after meeting him at a conference. And before I continue, I'll let Ariel pop in and give you some context on her situation.
The Denver Paper Fashion Show is, it's an annual fundraiser for the One Club for Denver. My idea was I wanted to have a transforming dress based off of that, something that was different. So the first thing I tried was I tried like pop-up flowers. So I made like pop-up book inspired flowers that the model, as she walked down the runway, could pull the string and then they would pop open. They were small, so you couldn't see them from the stage. So I'm like, I want something that's going to be bigger. It needs to be a bigger, impactful thing, like while she's walking down the runway. So then the fashion show got canceled for 2 years because of COVID. So I had lots of time to think about it over COVID. And I was like, I'm definitely going to try a transforming dress. I still didn't know what I was doing. I got them to do what I wanted to, but I didn't realize that the batteries don't last that long. So this year I was like, okay, it didn't work how I wanted to. So I want to make it bigger and better. And I want to, you know, really go for it this year. And then I met you. And then I was like, okay, now I've got extra resources.
Now, when they met at the aforementioned conference, they had talked a bit about animatronic fashion, Ariel had explained her predicament, and David had mentioned wanting to work together to solve said predicament. She then solidified this plan with her email and thus began our journey. Before they really started, David needed to get a general idea of the project goal, so Ariel sent some concept drawings and video inspiration. David did some research and decided to do a sort of budget version of Cameron Hughes' dress, but using normal servos and the CodeX. Then came the first test. Okay, this is where it gets really technical and I have to read this off of a paper because this did not come from my brain. All right. The CodeX can drive up to 4 servos directly from its peripheral connectors, but Ariel's design called for 8 independently controllable flower petals on the dress, 4 on the front and 4 on the back. So, first step was to add a servo driver board to the CodeX using the expansion connector. This cheap and cheerful one can handle up to 16 servos, which was perfect. Based on the concept drawings, David modeled up a belt-worn servo holder in Blender. So it was just a small matter of 3D printing a couple of them and they were ready for servos. Once David had a solid prototype, he sent this video to Ariel.
Okay, so this is the CodeX fashion motif. We've got 2 belt-worn servo hubs here, and we also get a little remote switch so that our model can click the switch to cycle to the next animation. So we're gonna try a few right now. So right now we're in the all down position for all these arms, and we're gonna click this external button and it's gonna execute that. We click it again, it'll execute all to the midpoints. So now it's going to the midpoint. Now they're gonna go all to the upmost position. And then we're gonna fan out. Everybody's gonna fan out slowly. Now they're all fanned out from across 180 degrees there. It's gonna do a little crisscross animation. And then here's the nice flutter effect. Can't wait to see that on the real dress.
Ariel was extremely hyped about the test, as you can see. And with a bit more back and forth, she sent her own test video. And with even more back and forth, some expedited shipping, and a hypothetical failure at the actual fashion show that we don't speak of.
We did it.
And we did it.
Don't even talk about the day, but we did it.
It does work. We did it, yeah.
And thus ends this epic tale, once again proving the versatility and just overall awesomeness of the CodeX. As always, happy coding.